Welcome to Workout B of the 14-Day Fat Loss System. I've had a lot of requests to put Workout B on YouTube to follow the nutrition program within the 14-Day Fat Loss. Today I've gone with a pair of 8s, a pair of 12s and a 16-kilo kettlebell. As explained in the manual, you can just use one pair of dumbbells, say 8s or even 5s, and use those for all exercises. For today I wanted to challenge myself a little bit more, so I've gone through a different variety to push myself. So you should know your own body by now if you got to Workout B. And as a beginner, maybe a pair of 5s. If you're intermediate, a pair of 8s. Advanced, you can go difference 8s, 12s, 16 kilo kettlebell. I want to start off with some stretches first. So we're going to do some foam rolling to start off with. We're going to take care of the upper back and the lats, just the shoulder blade area, just about 30 seconds or so. You can put your hands behind your head. You can get a little stretch over the foam roller, just to really warm up the upper back. Spend a little bit of time on each lap, so on the side, put your arm out to the front here, hand behind the ear, and just roll back and forth, just to push those knots out of the lats in the back of the shoulder. Okay, and do the other side. Right behind the shoulder, they're nice and high on the lats, arm up over you, hand behind the ear, roll back and forth. You can spend more time on that if you like. I'm going to move on to the next one. This is a push up with a downward dog, just to warm up the shoulders and stretch the calves and the hamstrings out. So push up position onto your toes. One push up, heading to a downward dog. Stretch the calves. Push up position again. Down, stretch the calves. Couple of those. Go into the splits next, just to warm up the inner thighs. Just take it as wide as you want. Hands go down to the ground. If you can't do so, you can just rest up here and focus on stretching your inner thighs. If you want to open up the low back, you relax the head down to the ground. Slowly walk your hands over to one shoe. Focus on that stretch on this side. Here, and you're also going to need the low back and the lats on this side. Stretch. And other side. Get into our first exercise, dumbbell renegade row with dumbbell wood chop. So we're going to go 3 sets back to back, set of 10 each on the renegade rows, and we've got 10 wood chops each way. So follow me here. So push up position, dumbbells right underneath the shoulders, wide feet to give a bigger base of support, and we're going to row one up to the body and take it down. We've got a set of 20. 3, 4. Trying to keep the hips as still as you can. So, dumbbell wood chop, put one hand on the dumbbell, other hand on top. We're going to do squat, up to shoulder height, pivot that foot, and down we're going to alternate. Set of 20, which is 10 each way. And that's your dumbbell wood chop. Rest for 30 seconds and complete that 3 times. We'll move on to the next superset. Okay, next exercise in Workout B is dumbbell squats with dumbbell shoulder presses. I'm gonna move on to my 12s now. You can just keep them by the side. Make sure your feet are slightly wider than shoulder width apart. Shoulders are back, you're gonna keep your chest up. As you hinge from the hips, sit back and push up. I'm going to set a 15. 2, 3. dumbbell shoulder presses. I like to keep them neutral grip, just to prevent any further shoulder injuries. Soften the knees, lift your gaze, press straight up over the head, walk them out, down for 2 seconds, up for one, 15. Rest for 30 seconds, complete that two more times. Okay, last superset in workout B is a split squat and then a dumbbell upright row. Split squats, no weights, hands behind the head. Why it's called a split squat? Because it still is a squat stance, squat width. Take one leg forward, one leg back, hands behind the head. Make sure we bend both knees, dropping down and push up. We've got a set of 15. Change legs, squat stance, other leg back, hands behind the head. And down, 15. Next one, dumbbell upright row. You can see in the diagram, it's got the squat in there. So, dumbbell between the legs, squatting down, using your legs, majorly using your legs as you snap up. Elbow comes up about shoulder height. We don't want to go too high on this one. We don't want to get any more upper trap recruitment. So down using your legs, 15, 2. Rest for 30 seconds. Complete that two more times. Last bit of supersets before we move on to our metabolic conditioning. Okay, so I hope you've taken about a 60 second break, maybe up to 2 minutes after your last superset. We're now gonna move on to metabolic conditioning. You'll need a kettlebell or a dumbbell and just your body weight. So the first one is just kettlebell swings. So you're gonna hinge from the hips, bum goes backwards, snap up to shoulder height. That's your kettlebell swing, making sure we're not rounding out through the low back. Our last one in that superset is just a push-up hold, hands right underneath the shoulders, and just holding for 30 seconds. We have 15 rounds of that in a metabolic conditioning at the end of workout B. So I'm gonna set my timer, and we're gonna go for it. Okay, here we go, first round, kettlebell swings, 30 seconds, we're snapping the hips, so we need high intensity. Hinge and go. You can see I'm not resisting with the kettlebell on the way down. I'm just letting it take me into my next swing. I'm squeezing the glutes at the top to make sure most of the movement is coming from my hamstrings and my glutes. Five more seconds. And stop. Into a push-up position on the ground. We've got 3 seconds. 2, 1, hold. Keep holding. Just tighten the abs. Lock out the elbows. Shoulders are back and down, away from your ears. And holding. Tighten the quads. 2, here we go, 2, 1, go. That's it. Come backwards. Inch from here, snap it up, shoulder high. Three sets down. Should be feeling this one already. Into our fourth set. We've got 15 rounds. If you're not sweating by now, you're not working hard enough, but the kettlebell's not heavy enough, or you're not snapping those hips explosive enough, keep your core tight, inch from the hips. Six. two rounds left. Stay with me. Here we go, I'm 14. Good job. That completes workout B of the 14-day fat loss system. You can purchase it from my blog, trovanspenia.com. Stay tuned for new ebooks and tips and specials coming out soon. See you soon.